Okay, sí. Sí, in some place you have Catholic protection, then Mr. Karthik Jain, why do we use Catholic protection?
Yes, sir. Sir, Cathode is also it's also similar like to protect from corrosion.
Okay, protect your vessels, tanks from
Metal
corrosion.
from corrosion.
So in a area, if we have cathodic protection, then at such places, see, cathodic protection, you have two type. One is your sacrificial anode, one is impressed current method. Okay. Now, when you are using this cathodic protection, particularly the sacrificial anode method, there what will happen is your earthing conductor, if you use copper, that copper may sacrifice itself. Okay. So you have to be very careful when there is a cathode protection. Please don't use copper. Okay. Next is, I have to size my earthing conductor. For that, I have to get the fault current. Okay. Now, see, there is something called chemical treated earth pit. Mr. Armugam, you have come across this chemical treated earth pit?
Yes, in case the resistance is very high, they have some chemical which can be added to the earth pit to reduce the resistivity.
Okay, so later on I will tell you why, how that works and why it works. Okay, I will explain
Okay.
later. Okay, as far as this chemical treated earth pit calculation is concerned, it is proprietary to the people who supply it, so we will not go into its calculation. Okay, then there's one more concept called deep bore earthing. There, just like your bore well pipe, no, deep, they will bore pipe deep into the earth and they will do it. Then there's one more concept called auxiliary earth mat. I will explain about that also. Okay, then after we do all this, what is the next thing is, we will determine the resistance of the earth grid. We have to determine this thing. I will not go much deep into it, because this what I will do is, when we actually take up the calculations, I will explain this other part of this this one. Basically, what we do in earthing design is, we have to determine how many horizontal conductors are there, how many vertical conductors are there. Okay, so then we have to, after determining all this, we have to determine the combined resistance of the earth grid, and then we have to prepare a layout. And when we do a layout, what all needs to be earthed? Mr. Shankar, can you tell me what all needs to be earthed in a plant?
Most of the plants has to be earth.
Yeah,
They need to
what
earth
all? Just give me some
plant.
typical names. What all need to be earthed?
Transformers or any plant with steels and pipelines or containers or furnaces.
Correct. All this needs to be earthed. And our panel, our electrical room, our UPS, all this need to be earthed. Right. Now, all this finally, we have to estimate the total quantity. For that, we prepare the bill of quantity. So, final deliverable at the end is, see, first we have to prepare the earthing calculation, but the site guy is not bothered about the earthing calculation. Site guy needs two things. One is the earthing layout, and one is the bill of quantity. The supply chain guys need the bill of quantity so that he can order the item. Okay. Okay, so so I've told the objective of the earthing design. Number one, we have to do the sizing of the earthing conductor. Number two, we have to determine the earthing system resistance. Then we have to determine the number of vertical rods and the horizontal rod. We have to prepare a layout. We have to estimate the total quantity, and we have to prepare the bill of material. Okay. And regarding the material to be used, I have explained it can be copper, aluminium, or steel. Copper we cannot use at cathodic protection. Okay, in places they don't use aluminium in this geo. This one, what is it? Where the certain places they don't use. I'm not getting the name. I will tell later. Then The earthing material depends on the owner specification, type of site. Where we use impress current protection, we cannot use copper, okay? And galvanized iron, galvanized steel is good. And above ground, below ground, we should that also we should be very careful. That also I'll explain. Then, okay. So for today, I will stop here. Do you have any doubts on today's class? Please, one by one, Mr. Armugam, any doubts on today's class?
Nothing, sir. Nothing for today. I'm okay.
If you get any doubt, you please put it on the message also. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, then I will explain. Okay. And Mr. Karthik, any doubt on today's class?
No, sir. Not.
Okay.
No, sir.
Okay. Mr. Shankar, any doubt on today's class?
I have one, sir.
Yeah.
Why is touch and step potential not applicable to this one?
Yeah.
Because still we got a fault current, right?
Yeah. See, it is like this actually. And every time people ask me this, the first thing is, whenever you touch any item, see, I'm not touch potential is a potential. Okay. Potential will be there, whether it is a substation or a building, it will be there. Touch potential will be there in a building also. But the thing is, the calculation method in building is different. In other words, in a substation, the calculation method they do using the touch potential. In a building, instead of calculating the potential, we do calculation via the resistance. One big reason I will tell you, in a substation, the fault takes place here at one city. It travels via the earth hundreds of kilometers to the other city. Whereas in a building or industry, when the fault takes place at a panel, the fault current will flow to the transformer, which is few hundred meters, not kilometer. And that too, it will not, major current will not flow through the earth. It will flow via the earth strip. So here, the earth loop impedance matters more. Okay. So the calculation method is different. So IEEE 80, the method they will use the touch potential. Whereas BS7430 or our IS3043, the calculation is based on the resistance. Finally, voltage is nothing but current into resistance, right? So there we check the voltage. Here we will check the resistance. It's only the calculation. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So any other doubts?
Yes, sir. Sir, I have one doubt with respect to fault current calculation.
Okay.
Sir, it was 1.4 kiloampere into 16, right?
Yeah.
Sir, how did you get that 16?
See, this fault current calculation in the later part, no? I am explaining. There is a slide on it that
okay,
I will
yeah.
do in detail.
Okay, sir. No problem.
Okay. And I will also give you some reference material where you can read more also. Okay. So, I will just note down. I will give you some reference material on fault current calculation. And I will also share you some reference material on cable construction. Okay. Okay.
Sir, can I ask you a common question?
Yeah, sure.
Do you do anything on per unit calculation?
Per unit calculation actually is a deep, it is again a big subject. I will not be able to cover here, but there is a book by Power System Analysis by Stevenson. So you can go through that book, but I will try to explain you in brief. Okay.
No, what I'm asking is, would you be able to do as a different session or something?
Pardon?
No, would you be able to do it as a different session, like in the sense later on when you are prepared?
But when I prepare, I will surely let you know. But for the timing, I will give you some links where you can go through.
Oh, okay.
So anything else for today's session?
No, thank you very much.
Okay. So, Mr. Armugam, anything?
Nothing, sir. Thank you so much for your time.
Okay, sir. Any doubts, please put it in the group. We will share. I will also share some material. Today, I am not giving any assignment. But in the next session, I will give some assignment. And when I give some assignment, you can work out at home using Excel or calculator. And you can give me the result via the WhatsApp itself so that we can cover more. Okay. Thank you, everybody, for this session today. See you tomorrow.
Thank you, sir.
Tomorrow,
thank you very much.
Join maybe 5 minutes earlier. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. Yeah, bye.
Have a good night.